Hey boys and girls, welcome back. Now since my last crazy slime video did so well, I figured I'd try doing another one for you. Except this time, we'll be looking at make your own mermaid slimy gloop. Slime set is suitable for kids ages 6 and up. Includes everything you need. Yeah, we'll see about that. Here is the side of the box. Now let's open the box and see what's inside. This looks like it's going to be pretty easy. Here is everything all laid out. Let's take a closer look at everything. Here's the measuring cup. Sodium tetraborate. I'm probably mispronouncing that. Clear beads. Plastic spoon. Mixing stick. Sequin mix. And our glitter glue. Oh wait. Can't forget the instructions. Of course, there are two things not included, which you also need. One paper or plastic cup. I don't have either, so I'm just going to use styrofoam. Second thing you'll need is warm water. Okay, step one. Use the measuring cup and pour 60 milliliters of warm water into the cup. Here's the thing. The measuring cup only holds 30 milliliters. So you'll need 2 cups of warm water. And here's the second one. Okay, now we need 1 even spoonful of the sodium tetraborate. Be very careful not to spill this. You might want to get an adult to help you. Stir that into the cup of warm water until everything is completely dissolved. Now, while that's dissolving, go ahead and get the sequin mix ready by opening the label. Do the same for the clear beads as well. Now get the glitter glue and add it to the tetraborate solution. Instructions say to add as much as you like. So I guess that's what I'll do. And just a little more. Now stir with the mixing stick. Looking pretty good. Let's just add a tad bit more. Thank you. Once you're done mixing, let it sit for a few seconds. Now grab the slimy gloop with your hands and work in the tetrabort solution to create a fun and slimier texture. Now add the sequins into the slimy gloop. You know what? I don't think I like this as much. The sequins kind of hurt my hands. I can see adding the sequins to finish off the look of the slime, but if I'm going to be playing around with it some more, I'd probably hold off on adding the sequins. Now let's add the clear beads. Yeah, I'm not really a big fan of this either. You really have to embed it into the slime for it to stick, otherwise it'll fall right out. What do you guys think? Does it remind you of a mermaid? Let's hold it against the box and do a comparison. Not bad. The only thing missing is the orange clownfish. Okay, final thoughts. I really like this. The slimy gloop came out looking great. The thing that surprised me the most was how easy it was to set up. Hardly any mess either. This was way easier to deal with than the Cra-Z-Art slimy creations gloop I made a few months back. The only thing I didn't like were the sequins and clear beads. Like I said, they hurt my hands. But hey, the gloop came out looking great, so I can't complain there. Make your own mermaid slimy gloop comes recommended. Alright guys, leave me a thumbs up, questions and comments below. See you in the next toy video.